Dear students, this lab is about the effects of a proportional derivative controller. We are going to analyze the performance of a proportional derivative controller in MATLAB for first and second order systems. First of all, we need to know a few things about the step response of a system. This figure here represents a few important parameters, a few important characteristics. You might have discussed these things in detail in your theory class. The first thing that you see is the rise time. This is the output to a step input for a system, and the time it takes to rise from the 10% to 90% value is 90% value of the steady state. It has to achieve the steady state at some point in time. So the time it takes to reach from 10 to 90% is the rise time of this response. Once the response settles to a value, we said the time required to achieve that settling state is the settling time, represented as TS, while the delay time is the time required to reach 50% value of the final value. There is another important characteristic, that is overshoot, and overshoot is basically the difference between the maximum peak and the steady state value. So overshoot occurs when the signal exceeds the desired steady state value, and it's just a peak, it's momentary sometimes, and we do not quite want this to happen. So in most of the applications we would want to reduce the overshoot as possible. Let's talk about the proportional derivative controller. When we combine a proportional and a derivative controller, we can achieve a PD controller. The purpose of a proportional gain is to stabilize a lower order system. So a lower order system, that is a system of first order, can be stabilized using proportional gain, KP. But for higher order systems, to gain stabilization, we need some other factors as well. The proportional controller is not enough in this case. Rather, we have to keep changing KP to a very high value. But if we are increasing the value of the proportional gain, but a very slight change will be observed in case of higher order systems. That is why we move on to the derivative controller. And derivative controller is used when we see that the error prediction can improve the control. It means that if we can predict the error in the system and we manipulate that particular value of the error, we take derivative of that output and make corrections to our system, then the error would be minimum as possible. So the derivative control comes in hand when we have to eliminate any sudden change, because if we were experiencing a very normal behavior of a system and then all of a sudden for a particular input there is a sudden change which we were not expecting, it means that we want to see the error and we want to take derivative of the error. It means whenever we take derivative of a variable, we are observing the behavior of the change of that particular variable. So if we get to observe that behavior, we can tweak the values and we can tune the system to eradicate that value. The table here shows the effects of proportional and derivative controller on system performance. So whenever we change KP, the rise time decreases and so does the delay time, while settling time observes very little change. The overshoot, however, increases and the steady state error also gets decreased. In case of KD, when the derivative controller is only implemented, there is a little change in rise time and delay time. The settling time decreases. The settling time decreases, and so does the overshoot. But in case of steady state error, we experience very small change. As I told you that this particular controller is helpful for sudden changes in our outputs. Let's study this effect with the help of an example. It's a basic RC circuit, a first order system. You already know how to calculate the transfer function of this from the knowledge of your previous courses as well. Tau here is the product of R and C. Now we are going to write a MATLAB code to implement a PD controller. This is an error here and I cannot edit it. It's in PDF. It should be PD controller. Okay. So we have to first write the transfer function in MATLAB. Now you know numerous ways to write the transfer function. I am going with the numerator and denominator formation using the TF command. So this is the open loop transfer function. The second step is I have to find out the step response of this open loop system by giving the step input to this system. We have done the similar things in previous labs as well. But now we are going to measure the performance parameters that are rise time, settling time, delay time and overshoot. So you have to take the snapshot of this step response and note down these values. You can also, this command also returns you these values in your command window. After this, we have to add a proportional controller in the system. So when we add the controller, now the system it becomes a closed loop system. And the feedback command would be used here. The command is given right here and you are using 100 value for KP. It means that 100% you are just using a value of 100 as the proportional gain. After that, after making this closed loop system, you have to find out the step response of the system and measure these same parameters again and compare the two. What effect has happened after adding this proportional controller? Okay, the next step is that we have to add a derivative controller to this. Now we are adding a derivative controller in addition to our proportional controller. The commands are given right here. You just have to follow these commands, but see the values. You can change the values to observe the effects as well. And perform the same steps. You have to observe the step response of your system by using the step command. This is the observation and calculation table, because all the steps that were mentioned above, they have to be done for particular values of R and C. So these are the values of R and C. Keep changing the values of the proportional and derivative controller gains to the values given here in the table and note down your observation in these tables. The second task is you have to take second order system of your own choice. So every student will come up with a second order system of his or her own choice and repeat the same activity for a PD controller for your particular system. So this is an individual submission, individual task. Please fill in the values here and you do not have to write another file. You do not have to make another lab report separately. Just fill in the values in the same tables. Write your names and registration number on top of the page and conclude your lab report by giving remarks. What did you learn from these activities? That's all for today's lab.